Hello, this is Lovesong and Yolanda from your One Day Experience Tibet. We are going to answer some of the questions people who once go to Tibet. So what's the question?
The question this time is a really good one and very common. It is, what are the main my main concerns are visa and permits. So they didn't actually ask a question, but their main concerns are visas and permits. So this is a very common question, actually, people ask how to go. So there are two main things that you should know. One is that you need a visa and a permit. So the visa is a Chinese visa to get you into China. And the in addition to that, you need a permit that is like a special Tibet travel permit to get you into Tibet, or the Tibetan Autonomous Region, the TAR.
Those two is totally different, separate visa and permit. So Tibet is very special to get that kind of permit because, you know, Tibet is a very restricted area to go to, and you know, in TR area, so you have to have permit, but it's, this is not Chinese visa.
And the way you also get them in a different way. So the Chinese visa you get on your own. You yourself go to a Chinese consulate in your home country and apply for the Chinese visa and get it. And then the permit you must get through your Tibetan travel agency. So when you travel to the Tibetan Autonomous Region, you have to have a guide and an agency. You have to be on an official tour. The tour can be just one person, but you have to be on a trip with an agency. And then the agency will handle all of your permits. So that part is like super easy. It's and it's not that hard to get your visa also. We can put a post, we have a good post about some of the ins and outs of getting your visa, and we don't want to go on too long here, but we have a post about that. We'll put it in the link. For this video,
the most important getting visa is, like, you know, you shouldn't mention anything about Tibet. That's the critical, because if you say you are going to Tibet, then they will definitely reject you. So don't worry about it. You just say something going to China and name some of the cities. So that will do it.
Absolutely. Even if you're going to Kham and Amdo, the areas outside of the Tibetan Autonomous Region, still don't mention anything about you're doing anything Tibetan. Sometimes you'll be rejected outright, and sometimes they will put you through this weird process that is a loop that is basically going to reject you. So if it makes some people, it makes them feel really uncomfortable. They feel like they're lying when they make their visa application if they don't say that they're going to Tibet. But you should consider this. The Chinese government allows you to have one, to say whatever your itinerary is on your visa application, and then you can change your mind, because there can be a month, several months or more, from the time that you've made your application for your visa until you go. So you're allowed to change your mind about your itinerary. So it's, not to worry that you're just putting your general itinerary, which doesn't include Tibet, and then you can change your itinerary to include Tibet, and that's perfectly legal and allowed. So you're not lying or doing anything weird, or you can think of it that way. Okay?
Thank you so much. I hope this helpful for you.
Yep, we'll come back with more questions another time.
Thank you.